Hi, myself Apurvi Jyoti. Today we are going to learn about when are they going to weave the saris, what type of temperature should be needed for them and all. Between March and May, Jagatayya family is able to weave only for a few hours a day. So during the month of March and May, they are able to work only few hours to weave the sari. Why? Because the temperature is high, the threads will get cut. So if the temperature is more, they can't work for more hours. No, during summer season, can we work for more hours? No, right? If the temperature is more high, the threads will be breaking in between. They'll be not in strong manner. The whole family works only till afternoon during these days. So in the months of March to May, the family will be working only till afternoon, means like 12 or 1. Women are distressed as they have to do not only weaving but also the household chores like cooking food. So women get distressed due to that heatness. They get irritated, like they have to do weaving work, then they have to cook food for the family, they have to do all the cleaning work and all, fetch water, and they have to get the children from the school, feed them and all these works make them more tired. Earlier Jagatayya's family used to weave only for the cooperative societies. The cooperative societies provide financial assistance through insurance in case of unexpected illness or death in the weaver's family. So before days, Jagatayya family used to work under cooperative societies. Means these cooperative societies, what they do, they help the members of their society by giving the loans when they are ill, or if they want any money, if there is a need of money for them or raw material, they'll be helping them, group members, society members, by providing financial help, means giving money, or if they are like not feeling well, providing some help to them. If in case of death of the weaver, helping the family by giving money to them or giving work to them. They also help in getting loans for construction of houses. Not only for weaving saris, they even provide loans for if the members are asking them to give the loan for the construction of house and all. Even the cooperative societies give loan for them. Nowadays the cooperative societies does not give sufficient work, so they have to look for additional sources of income to run their families. Means now cooperative societies are also not able to give sufficient work for the weavers, then they are not getting good income, means sufficient income to run their families. For that, what they are doing, they are searching for another jobs, another income, means doing other work, they can get the income to run their families. They are searching for another jobs. Since the master weavers in Pochampally agreed to give work and remuneration, Jagatayya family began weaving ikat saris for the master weavers. Now what master weavers are doing, they are planning, they are preparing the designs and giving the work to the small weavers like Jagatayya and all. And they are giving remuneration, means they are paying some amount for the saris which these small weavers are making. Seeing the designs, the small weavers, what they do, they prepare the saris. For that, this big the master weavers, they pay some amount for weaving. Jagatayya has not given up the membership of the cooperative society with the hope that it will improve its functioning in the future. So what Jagatayya have done, no, I will not give up my membership, I will not come out of the group, because in future if I have any problem, if I need any help, this cooperative society may help me. Thinking this, he is continuing still as one of the member of cooperative society. So now let us see what are the problems these weavers may face. Weavers problems and cooperative societies. Telangana is one of the state in India which have a large number of handlooms. So Telangana is one of the state which have many handloom weavers, sari makers. During the last few decades, handloom weavers have been facing serious problems. So from few years, last few years, this handloom weavers who are there, they are facing many problems due to insufficient work or insufficient income. Let us see what are those problems. They face a stiff competition from powerloom and mill-made clothes. These clothes are cheaper as they are produced on machines. So they are facing competition from this powerloom and mill-made clothes. So these clothes, the clothes which are made in powerloom using machineries and mills, which they are made, they are being sold. The clothes which are made in powerlooms and this mill-made clothes, these clothes are sold at low prices in the market. So if these clothes are sold at low prices, what happens? Clothes which are made by this Jagathaya or the weavers, no, they are not being sold because the powerloom clothes are cheaper. We are getting at cheaper rates. Why we have to spend more amount on this handloom weaver cloth? So no one is purchasing that. And also because they use synthetic yarn which is cheaper than cotton or silk. So these handloom weavers use cotton threads and all. So cotton or silk they'll be using, handloom weavers. But this powerloom and mill cloths, cloths for them, they use silk. This synthetic yarn. This synthetic yarn they'll be getting for cheaper rates. So they are using more, producing more and selling for cheaper rates. But these handloom weavers, they are using cotton and silk yarn, which is costly, right? So they are no one is interested to purchase this handloom weaving sarees. Even though it is popular due to its high quality and unique beauty, the Pochampally saree seems to be expensive. Teacher, then why are these Pochampally saree weavers, they are putting high rates? Because they are using good quality of saree, good quality and quantity of sarees, silk threads they are using, and they make different designs when compared to other sarees. That is why these Pochampally sarees are expensive, means costly. The weavers also do not get good rates due to middlemen involvement. See this, what happened, this middlemen and all will be involved. These handloom weavers, after preparing, what they do, they sell these product, these sarees, to the middlemen, brokers and all. What they do, they give less amount to the handloom weavers, they purchase that, and these middlemen, they sell the sarees in the market for higher cost. The buyers are spread all over the world and weavers do not have any direct contact with them. So these middlemen, they get involved with the handloom weavers. They go to the handloom weavers and they buy the sarees for less cost and they sell in the markets for higher cost, right? So these handloom weavers will not have direct contact with the customers like us who will be purchasing the sarees. Fashions in cities changes fast and it is difficult for the weavers to know what kind of designs are in demand. Yes, this is also another problem. In cities, towns and cities, fashion changes very quickly. We adopt new fashion, new trends and all very quickly. So in order to get used to that designs and all, these handloom weavers have problems because they don't have great knowledge about the technology and all new designs. In order to adopt the designs and make the saree, takes time for them. But for power looms and made products, they adopt the technology, new designs easily, they make on the machine and they sell for the cheaper rates. Therefore, they have to rely on middlemen to know about the designs in vogue and chain. So these handloom weavers, they are depending on the middlemen because middlemen will give the print, means blueprint, copy of the design for the weavers and all. So till he send the copy, they have to wait, they have to understand. It takes time for them. They also have to depend on middlemen to the raw material like cotton or silk yarn as they are produced in far away centers. So in order to get this cotton or silk thread, again they have to depend on whom? Middlemen, because middlemen will be getting the raw material for the handloom weavers. These sari weavers, they buy the raw material from middlemen because they are produced very far, means in far places they are prepared. The silk yarn is prepared and the middlemen will be getting them for the weavers. This gives the middlemen an important position in the handloom industry and they try to get the largest share of the sari price. So this middlemen, what now, for everything they are depending on the middlemen. The position of the middlemen is important, means have been growing, is very important in the handloom industry, and he'll be getting large share, more income from the saris. If you like my video, please do like, share and subscribe. Thank you.